Welcome to Building a DD from Scratch, Episode 2, Important Buffs. So I will tell you right from the start, there are two very important buffs that you always need. If you don't have these two, you're not a good DD. And they are different for Magicka-based and Stamina-based characters. So for Magicka-based, it's Major Sorcery, grants 20% spell damage. Major Prophecy grants 10% spell crit. For stamina based, it's Major Brutality grants 20% spell weapon damage, and Major Savagery grants 10% crit chance. And then there is a third buff that you don't have to use, but if you want to be a good DD, you usually have it: Minor Force. Minor Force increases your crit damage by 10%, and it doesn't matter if it's magical or physical damage. So now let's look into this. The first ones I mentioned, Major Sorcery, Major Prophecy, you can get these from potions, and this is what you will see a lot in builds. So here we have a potion that restores Magicka, grants Major Intellect, it's also a buff, increase your Magicka recovery, and this is really important. This is the main reason for potions. But then here you get the Major Sorcery and Major Prophecy, and problem solved, you don't need to do anything else. And there's also a stamina variant of this, Warrior Elixir, or if someone crafts it, it's called differently. You can find them in stores, but there's a huge downside to these potions, and it's their cost. You want to drink a potion around every 45 to 60 seconds in a dungeon, simply to restore your resources, and one of these potions with these additional buffs on them costs around 200 gold. So you will be spending 200 gold per minute, and this is why I really don't recommend going after those high-end builds if you're a beginner, or even if you just want to look for some fun and are not an absolute tryhard. So how else can you get these buffs? There are some armor sets, but I don't really recommend these because these buffs do not stack. You can only have one instance of this buff up at a time, and there are very strong sets that you can just use that boost your spell damage a lot, that boost your magic a lot, that boost your crit, whatever, without these named buffs. And it's rather simple on most classes to get these buffs from certain skills or even passives. So on a Nightblade, let's look. I'm a Magicka based character, so I want Major Sorcery. We have this here in the siphoning tree. Step Essence grants Major Brutality and Sorcery, so you could use it for both. Increase weapon and spell damage by 20%. Now this skill is cast around you and has a radius of 8 meters. Now we are using a staff, and most of our skills have a range of 28 meters. So you see the problem here, you don't really want to jump in. Like, I do, but not everyone likes this kind of playstyle. And then you think, okay, so I don't really want to use this, so I have to use the potion. Yeah, not really. There's another way you can get it with every single class. Major skilled, second skill, and then entropy. And the morph degeneration will also give you spell damage. Major sorcery for 20 seconds. And has a range of 28 meters as well, so you can use this if you want instead. Good, that's the first problem covered. Then Major Prophecy. On mage characters, this is a no-brainer. You can always simply slot Inner Light on your bar. You don't even have to activate it, simply by being slotted grants you Major Prophecy, 10% crit chance, and even increases your maximum magicka, which again boosts your damage further. There are some classes which also can grant this buff somehow to themselves. And yeah, again, almost every class has a way to give themselves Major Brutality or Sorcery. There are a few exceptions. Templars. Templars cannot give themselves Major Brutality. So then you would have to look somewhere else. For example, in two-handed you can get it, Major Brutality. In dual wield you can get it. Now what if you are a Templar with two bows? Yeah, it's a bad idea, and this is, again, you have to do some research, look into all the skills, and this is why I'm making this video. You really have to only, if you plan a character, You have to decide what resource you want to use, what type of damage your skills will be, and then you have to look, how will I get these buffs? And on a Templar with two bows, there is no way for you to get major brutality. So you will always lack 20% weapon damage unless you use the potions, which cost 200 gold a second. So this is really what I want to tell you, and you should look into this. Every other class... Actually, no, necromancers too. Necromancers also cannot give themselves this. So if you want to make a bow, stamina necromancer, you will have a problem. Every other class can give themselves major brutality, and as we have seen, mage classes, there's no single mage class that cannot get this, because simply from the first two skills in the major skill, you get the major prophecy and the major sorcery. Alright, so much for those very important buffs that every DD needs. Now there's a third one, which is Minor Force. Minor Force increases your critical damage done by 10%. And you can find it on Trap Beast in the Fighter skill. It's a stamina ability, so in case of a Magicka character, it deals very little damage, but still the Minor Force is worth it. But then again, there's still a downside to the skill, which is it's a trap and it only activates, even the buff only activates after someone walked into the trap. And on a ranged character, this isn't always so easy to do. So if you don't want this, you could use Psychic Order, Channeled Acceleration, the skill right here. And you cast this for 1.3 seconds, so it's one of the few buffs that you actually have to channel. And then you have Minor Force for 36 seconds. This is how it looks, that's the cast, and now 36 seconds, 10% increased critical damage done. These are really the big three, buffs that you need, that you should watch out for. I mean, the Minor Force is kind of a luxury thing, especially while leveling, you don't really need it, but later on, if you want to maximize your damage, it's a really good idea to get either this or the trap. And then, let's talk about one more buff. It's not strictly for damage, but even damage dealers should most of the time use it. And every single class has access to this somehow. It's Major Resolve. And Major Resolve is a skill that grants you 5280 spell and physical resistance, which is quite a lot. Will make you a lot more tanky, even on the DD, or let's say especially on the DD. And most classes, for example Dragon Knights, they grow some spike armor. Wardens, they get some ice armor that also spreads to other team members. What else do we have? Necromancers can grow bone armor. Templars can make a rune focus, so they can create an area where they get this buff. And Nightblades are a little bit different, that's why I want to mention them here. You will not find any skill. You will wonder, hey, where can I get Major Resolve? And the answer is, it's in a passive from the Shadow Tree. And this says, whenever you cast a Shadow ability, you will get this buff, Major Resolve, for 6 seconds. And you can buff this duration by equipping one or two pieces of heavy armor. So I have two pieces of heavy armor, the duration is buffed by 50%. So in total I get this for 9 seconds. And there are some nice skills in the Shadow Tree. Veiled Strike, or you could use your Shadow Cloak if you want. But I think the most reasonable ones are either Twisting Path or Shade. Twisting Path actually seems pretty nice because it lasts 10 seconds, it increases your speed. So here we have another buff, Major Expedition. I mean, you kind of want that, but it's not absolutely necessary on a DD. But usually it's also a good idea to look for Major Expedition somewhere in your skill set, just in case you want to run somewhere fast. Anyway, if I use this skill now and I have this passive, I will get the Major Resolve. So I don't even have to slot a dedicated skill to get this on a Nightblade. You can just use the skill and here, Major Resolve. Alright, yeah, this is already it. Really wanted to raise your attention to these three big ones. So you want to raise your spell damage, weapon damage, spell crit or weapon crit, depending on what you play, and your crit damage. And you have to really watch out. Depending on what weapons you want to use on a stamina character, you should inform yourself before if it's possible to get these buffs or not. Next video, I will talk about armor and armor types. Alright guys, hope you enjoyed it. See you next time.